Hi there, Paul from Spitfire Audio here. I'm very excited today to show you Orbis, our collaboration with the legendary explorer and composer David Fanshawe. With over 3,000 sounds and an almost infinite set of creative treatment possibilities, this is a totally new sonic palette being passed from one generation to the next. Many film scores use instruments from different cultures to create a rich hybrid sound. Orbis will give you access to sounds for your scores that few people have heard. Expand your horizons beyond the orchestra. A supremely gifted engineer, David left an incredible archive of sounds, meticulously recorded during his explorations of the world, befriending people from different cultures, capturing music and instruments that in some cases no longer exist. He had the composer's ear, and would know exactly where to place his mics for best effect. David's recordings have been used in films as diverse as 7 Years in Tibet and Gangs of New York, and now they can power your next score too. Now you can seed your music with the DNA of countless cultures from around the world, celebrating the fusion of a new cinematic music with the best source materials in existence. Take a step into a thrilling new world of sonic possibilities. Let's dive straight in. So just to give you a very quick example right at the word go, a kind of immense, almost kind of Blade Runner type synth created, at least in part, from an antelope horn. So let's start by looking at a clean sound, and then we'll look at the different ways that those have been treated already before they actually reach the eDNA engine. So here is a recording of some bell stones. Now, as you can hear, this is one of the loops menus, so you have a variety of different kinds of performances. Not only that, but also if within your door you change the BPM, you'll see that the loops match the BPM, and really easily you can even do tempo ramps within a piece of music and everything just stays absolutely in sync. Now, these are the raw sounds, so these are the actual beautiful original recordings made by David. We have then treated these recordings in a variety of different ways. As you can see, there are two bays to load the sounds into. So if I open here in Bay A, you'll see all of the different options within this menu, lots and lots of different stuff. And if we go into the bellstones and quickly look through the different treatments here. So here's with distortion starting to break the sound up. That's with a really intense crunch sound. Slightly dirtier kind of distortion. This one's built from a variety of different types of sound with some phasing, some LFO work, and we've got a great kind of shimmer sound with a beautiful kind of depth and texture to it. Now, from these sounds, you can then create further sounds using the immense power of the eDNA engine. So we'll go into that shortly. But first, let's check out some of the other sounds within these menus where you can sample lots of different recordings from different areas. I'm just going to flick through the menu, but as you can see here, there are lots of different ways you can search for sounds using the tagging system that's built in to the browser. You can see there's lots of different performances here. Now, if we just wanted to take a sound and we wanted to have some kind of beautiful reverb around that, sit it in the distance and maybe make it sound a little bit more kind of radio-like for the back of, you know, the context of your score, that's incredibly simple. I'm going to show you how to do that right now. So I'm going to turn up the release. I'm going to go into the effects side. I'm going to turn on my filter here, go to the sends menu, and then I'm going to put on some reverb, a little bit of delay, set my pre-delay nice and big, and then we've got so the ability to shape the sound to exactly how you want it is very, very straightforward. I'm going to click on clean so that we're looking at just the clean menus now. And then let's try China F. Let's have a listen to India D. So incredibly easy to get exactly the right kind of dynamic, the right kind of performance, at exactly the tempo of the track that you need it. And one quick listen of something else from the clean section, so Zanzibar. So you get the idea, and a lot of these sounds can be really incredibly useful for building up a track from scratch. They're fantastically useful for hip hop, for dropping in a little section of recording and then using that as a sample, and really, really useful for creating atmospheric sounds as well, which we'll dive into now. So as you can see, when we go into the playable loop section, we've got a whole ton of amazing presets where these sounds are loaded into the two bays. There's some treatment set up for you. It's incredibly simple to just load and play, and it's got a kind of vibey sound. And the mod wheel is always set to do something. And in these presets, the sounds are spread across the keyboard. So you can play in exactly the right key for your track. I'm going to show you a few of my favorite sounds. So it's almost kind of giving you using these gongs in a tuned keyboard style almost gives you that kind of feel of the steel pan rhythms and textures that Cliff Martinez used in Solaris. And some of these Tibetan bells and gongs are exactly the same instruments that we used in the score for 7 years in Tibet. Here we're using some of the marimba recordings, some of the loop instruments, but then using different treatments that put them in a kind of slightly different context. Now, obviously, you can use these instruments just by playing the first sound of the loop as well, although there are playable instruments as well. We'll come to those in a minute. And this kind of almost brings you into a kind of EDM area. That kind of thing. So there's lots and lots of different sounds. And again, we're not really using the full power of the eDNA engine yet. These are just the treatments of the original raw sounds that are in there waiting for you to kind of take them and make them into whatever you want. So here you're getting a kind of rhythmic texture as well. There's a slight pitch undulation, and things like this that tempo lock to your tracks are incredibly useful for filling out background texture, for giving your ear something really intriguing to latch onto as the rest of the track is kind of developing around you. It's almost like a kind of super powered steroid version of the original Brunel loops that we used in the Albion. But these are so much more textured and deeper because of the fact that they're built from these incredible source recordings. So the way that you play these can obviously, you can play it just completely straight. So you get that very clear rhythmic part, or you can kind of spread the rhythms around and get a kind of more, almost like this kind of swarm undulation of sound. Which gives a really interesting texture as well. So there I'm just varying the amount of reverb with the mod wheel. Again, you can set this into a setting. Almost makes me think of Black Hawk Down, fantastic Hans Zimmer score, which blends the amazing North African players with the kind of Western sound. There's a kind of rocky sound and also an orchestral bed. With these kind of incredible recordings here, you've got access to making these kind of amazing hybrid scores, which will bring a whole new kind of color palette to your work. So again, here you've got two very diverse sounds with their treatments that are kind of giving you a great kind of rhythmic pulse. You've also got the oscillate mixer working here, so it's oscillating between the two bays. Really configurable, easy to set up. Just check out the great videos that the support team have made on how it works. But also within the eDNA engine, you have this great gate sequencer as well. Now I'm just setting up a quick pattern here. I'm going to turn off the master convolution reverb, which is giving you that big wash, so you'll be able to hear very clearly the sound pre-reverb. It's super easy to set up any kind of pattern in there to get any of these sounds really motoring along as rhythmic things in their own right. If you want to use that kind of gated effect, that can be really nice in tracks as well. Okay, the last one I'm going to play from these playable loops section. So you can often, by pitching a lot of these sounds down, find an interesting new tonality. And here, this is a kind of major tonality, which you can then use either in this, if I'm playing it in C major, you're getting a C, D, G, but you could also use that over an A. Just to give you a vague idea of how that might work. So there's lots of different ways of using the even the stuff that has a kind of inherent melodic pattern to it. Okay, so if we look at the one shots, and we're going to load up the China menu now and just have a listen to the variety of different sounds that you've got within this section of the library. So some of these are just single notes, some of them are longer phrases, and some of them are embellished versions of a single note. So if you want to dive deeper into any of these sections, then we simply go to the One Shots playable section. Let's start with something like the Bronze Age gong. And again, super simple to just set up a little bit of delay on these. Let's put a bit of feedback, pan it around. So if I switch on the master send, then we've got our sends all set up. Simply turn on delay one. So this is a really great sound, Cheng sound. I'm going to turn up the releases on here, both sides. And again, just a really simple crossfade where you go into a version with more reverb. So very versatile, very useful for different kinds of things, different kinds of treatment. So this gives you a kind of obvious idea for what you might use this for. Anything from that kind of calliope type thing to that kind of almost kind of 60s mellotron sounding kind of part. And again, we can use kind of chorus flanging. Let's whack a couple of bits on. So the flanger on the master effects and then the chorus on bay A. So quick and easy to start making these sounds your own. Some great stuff here using a conch shell. And just having a playable patch of these beautiful sounds across the keyboard, really, really enjoyable to play. Here we've made a kind of synth out of that sound as well. And this is using the, as you can see, two sounds from here. You've got the breakup sound, which is that kind of edge of distortion. And then you've got the shimmer, which is our beautiful kind of secret sauce using all sorts of different bits and pieces of reverb and delay and everything. And then if you want to go, more towards kind of one side or the other, you can use the mod wheel to vary the texture as you're playing. These sounds make some fantastic drones. And again, it's very, very easy to stick on some interesting texture to just the master control. So pick a great long decay sound. Which gives you that really great. It's the thing that makes it different is using a really interesting, complex, textured source sound. So it's not just, you know, as great as those fantastic kind of 70s and 80s synths are, it's not just an analog synth going through a reverb. It's got all of the kind of spit and the texture and the randomness that you get from the source sound from these beautiful field recordings. And then that feeds into everything and just creates this multi-layered sound. And again here, you know, lots of different uses for this. So just a fantastically recorded horn sound gives you, with just a tiny bit of reverb there, as it is out of the box, set up, ready to go, gives you that kind of otherworldly, you know, alien craft kind of sound. I love that kind of little wobble at the end of that sound. It's a really great kind of swelling sound that goes to a kind of fantastic stop. And this is again made from the antelope horn. So lots and lots of different textures and sounds you can get from this. And it's almost like a kind of amazing kind of analog synth sound. So really, really useful, this kind of stuff. Got a whole incredible selection of pads. So we heard one at the beginning, this the great Blade Running pad. So what I love about this sound is it has a feel of those fantastic Fairlight samples from the 80s. You'll have heard in lots of productions. It's got that great kind of texture. And again, there as well, that kind of similar thing, using these sounds in a totally different context from the kind of original source recordings. Having that really wide variety of possibility only kind of enhances the usefulness of this. So I love the texture in that, and you're getting that from that kind of, this is kind of pitched down, and that kind of semitone drop at the beginning of the sound, and it seems to fall further and further off as you go. So that makes a really good pad sound. Again, some fantastic textures in there. Using the Summer Palace sound set in here, there's lots and lots of things going on in there, but you've got the already kind of distant treatment of the source sound, and then it's in the eDNA engine with various treatments going on there. So you're taking something which is an incredibly complex original source sound and making it into a kind of playable synth. But the beauty of it, as I keep mentioning, it's about texture, it's about kind of depth of sound, and having these really fantastic glistening moments that occur as the sound is kind of developing that just adds interest and depth to your music. And here you've got a really strong fundamental in there, which enables us to create this kind of amazing kind of almost, I don't want to say organic organ, but like a kind of, yeah, an organ of humanity that then has all of these incredible, instead of the mixtures that you might have in an organ where you're using harmonics, here you've got a constantly moving upper kind of set of almost harmonics that just gives you that very rich sound. So here, taking the horn and the drum sound and making it into a kind of textured pad that has a slight rhythmic element to it. Again, super textured, almost sounds like, you know, kind of peals or bells going on in the background, but you've still got a real strong fundamental for you to be able to play. A great chord, and then just allow the kind of wash to expand. Finally, from this section, a slightly simpler sound, but again, made from the horns, but this is kind of going in a more kind of string-like direction. And it's great to have something where you might traditionally use something like strings, but to have a sound that has the same effect, it does the same job, but is something that people will hear and they will just think, I've no idea what that is. I've never heard anything like that before. That's where the real magic is. So I'm going to take us back to the Senegal loops menu. And we've got some great sounds within this menu of sounds. So you might, if you wanted to find something that you could use, for example, if you're writing a kind of hip hop track, kind of beats track, and you want to find something that you're going to lock into it as part of your track, you can get a load of effects work done within the actual eDNA engine. So if we put on, for example, the phaser, and let's say that we were going to go into the bay, turn on a couple of these sounds. So if you want to get that kind of almost talkbox sound, but you want to control it from a different controller, we can pick, let's use the mod wheel, for example, simply control click, learn MIDI CC automation, move the mod wheel, and then instant. So all kinds of crazy stuff you can do. I won't go too far into this, but you can see there are loads and loads of great effects in there. And one final menu that we didn't check out earlier, the Sudan menu. There's tons of great stuff in here. Let's check out a little bit from the Laos menu. And as you can hear, I could hear that that would sound good faster. So just whack the tempo up and it just tracks to your tempo. So before we finish, quick look at Tanzania. Okay, that's a bit too fast. So again, some really exciting stuff in there. And last one, just have a quick look at Thailand. So thanks for watching this quick look through Orbis. It's an absolute encyclopedia of amazing recordings made by David Fanshawe on his travels, a source of DNA to infuse your music. In some ways, David was the original crossover artist making, fusing classical music and what we then subsequently called world music. But for him, music was just music. His motto was, "I love the world." He enjoyed finding amazing musicians all over the world, befriending them, recording their performances, and finding a way to kind of unite the musics of the world. This provides you with an amazing source. Film music throughout the years has often blended music from different cultures in creative ways to create a really rich kind of tapestry of sound. And it's not just the kind of epic cinematic kind of sound. A lot of these things can be made to sound very intimate, as you just heard. But also you've got an amazingly rich source of unique recordings to make beats with, for incredible hip hop tracks, you know, some great textures in there to use in your hip hop production. And you've got an amazing source of sounds, of course, you know, to use in natural history scoring. But it goes way beyond that. This is a really rich tapestry of sounds. It's almost like a new kind of world synth, which goes from the raw sounds that are incredibly useful all the way through to these beautiful, undulating, evolving textures made from these incredible organic recordings. I hope you're going to enjoy using this. We can't wait to see what kind of music you're creating with this. So please link us. Check out the other videos that are linked below for how to get really deep into the eDNA engine and use these incredible tools to make the sounds your own. So if you like this video, please hit like. If you have any questions, please leave them below in the comments section. And also, if you want to receive more information from us and get updated when we put new videos up, please subscribe and ding that little bell icon. Thanks very much for watching. See you on the next one. Bye-bye.